Number 5. Nobody is a 2021 American action thriller film directed by Elian A. Shuler. The movie follows a retired government operative named Hutch Mansell, played by Bob Odenkirk. Living a seemingly ordinary life, he chooses not to intervene during a home invasion, leading to the loss of dignity for his family. This incident reignites his desire for violence, prompting him to pursue and confront the burglars, setting off a chain of violent events. His past involves dark activities with special forces, and his actions lead to chaos and violence. However, his actions attract a larger, more dangerous threat involving deadly dark forces. Nobody received acclaim for its highly choreographed action sequences and darkly humorous tone.
Old man. I'm gonna fuck you up. It's been a hell of a day.
You can see that.
For 12 years, I worked for some very dangerous people. Everybody get to the basement.
What is happening?
Don't call 911. I used to be what they call an auditor. The last guy anyone wants to see at their door. Because it meant you didn't have long to live. But I left it behind to start a family.
Hey!
I might have, overcorrected.
When you left, you abandoned a certain debt that needs repayment, and your creditor is aware of your resurrection.
They came after my family.
They stole my kitty cat bracelet.
And you don't fucking do that! Give me the goddamn kitty cat bracelet!
You look like shit, Dad.
You should see the other guys.
Who the fuck are you?
Me? I'm nobody.
Number 4. Seeking Justice is a 2011 American action thriller film directed by Roger Donaldson. The story follows the protagonist, Will, played by Nicolas Cage, an ordinary high school teacher whose wife, Laura, played by January Jones, is critically injured in an attack. In the hospital, a mysterious stranger played by Guy Pearce offers a deal. He is willing to help Will seek revenge, but in return, Will must agree to assist him in a future task. In a state of emotional turmoil, Will accepts the deal. However, as he delves deeper, he discovers that the so-called Justice Organization is involved in a larger conspiracy. He begins to realize that things are not as simple as they seem. Throughout the story, Will becomes entangled in a complex and dangerous conspiracy, struggling to protect himself and his family.
Get the hell out of my life.
We should go to the cops. We tell them everything.
Some of them are cops.
When it's done, you call me.
A promise is a promise, Will.
You have no idea what this guy is capable of.
Where have you been? Thought I heard you walking around.
Sir, we have a warrant for your arrest for murder.
What the hell is happening?
I'm done.
Well, come back. I want to talk to you.
How long have you been following me?
Let's not forget what we did for you.
We're just a few citizens seeking justice.
Number 3. Prisoners is a 2013 psychological thriller film directed by Denis Villeneuve. The story is set in Pennsylvania and revolves around two families whose daughters go missing on Thanksgiving. Detective Loki, played by Jake Gyllenhaal, is assigned to investigate But due to a lack of substantial leads, progress in the case is slow. Unable to endure the pain of their daughter's disappearance, one father, Keller Dover, played by Hugh Jackman, initiates his own investigation and resorts to vigilantism against a man suspected to be involved in the disappearance. The film explores themes of morality, justice, extreme circumstances, and the choices parents may make under intense pressure. Prisoners is renowned for its intricate plot, outstanding performances, and suspenseful atmosphere.
I'm gonna find your daughter.
Show me your hands right now!
You put those girls somewhere, Alex.
No.
I know you put those girls somewhere.
He stays in custody until my daughter's found, right?
We have a 48-hour hold on. It ends tomorrow unless we bring charges.
We'll charge him with something.
That boy has never been in trouble, not a day in his life.
Well, this thing's clean. I'd start looking in the woods by the rest stop.
The police said they're letting him go today.
What you doing? Tell me! Well, no! Day six, and every day, she's wondering why I'm not there.
You told us that you could protect us from everything.
Why did you look for my daughter?
Alex.
What in the world did you do?
Someone has to make him talk, or they're gonna die.
We're not gonna help Keller, but we won't stop him either. Let him do what he needs to.
I know you know where they are.
Where's my daughter?
Number 2. The Equalizer is a 2014 action crime film directed by Antoine Fuqua. The story follows the protagonist, Robert McCall, played by Denzel Washington, who is a former Black Ops operative with a mysterious past. After leaving his dark past behind, he tries to lead a quiet life working at a hardware store. However, when he befriends a young woman named Terry, played by Chloe Grace Moritz, and discovers that she is being victimized by a Russian mob, McCall decides to take matters into his own hands. Using his exceptional combat skills and tactical knowledge, he becomes a vigilante, seeking justice for Terry and others who are helpless against criminals. The Equalizer is based on the 1980s TV series of the same name and successfully creates a tense and thrilling narrative, earning positive reviews from both audiences and critics.
Think you can be anything you want to be. Change your world. I promised I would never go back to being that person. But when somebody does something unspeakable to someone you hardly knew, you do something about it. Because you can.
I mean about a girl.
16 seconds.
You didn't take out five pimps. You took out the East Coast hub of the Russian mafia.
A man with his skill. I want to know who he really is.
He won't stop until he kills you and anyone you care about.
This goes all the way to the top. Had enough? Because I can keep going. Brick by brick, body by body. What do you see when you look at me? What do you see when you look at me?
It's too late to start over.
Number 1. Taken is a 2008 action thriller film directed by Pierre Morel. The story revolves around the main character, Brian Mills, played by Liam Neeson, a retired CIA operative, when his daughter Kim, played by Maddie Grace, is kidnapped while traveling in Europe. He embarks on a dangerous rescue mission. Brian utilizes his special skills to navigate through various locations in Europe, tracking down the kidnappers and saving his daughter. The film portrays the story of a father willing to do anything to protect his daughter, successfully blending action, thriller, and family element, making it a popular and well-received movie.
I don't know who you are. I don't know what you want. If you are looking for ransom, I can tell you I don't have money. But what I do have are a very particular set of skills. Skills I have acquired over a very long career. Skills that make me a nightmare for people like you.
Where are they?
If you let my daughter go now, that'll be the end of it.
You have a 96-hour...
What?
To never finding her.
No!
But if you don't, I will look for you.
Where is she?
I will find you. I will kill you.